This is the list of emergency drugs that we will discuss. First of all is atropine. Atropine is an antimuscarinic, parasympatholytic, and anticholinergic drug. This means that it blocks the action of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. Atropine is used in cases of severe bradycardia, meaning when the heart rate becomes very low, and in asystole, when the heart completely stops. It is also used in cases of mushroom and organophosphate poisoning. The dose of atropine in severe bradycardia and asystole is 0.5 to 1 mg, which can be administered every 3 to 5 minutes until the heart rate is restored. In mushroom poisoning, the dose is 1 to 2 mg, and in organophosphate poisoning, it is 1 to 6 mg. The route of administration for atropine is intravenous, meaning it is injected into the vein. The next drug is adrenaline, also known as epinephrine, which is a catecholamine and sympathomimetic agent. Adrenaline is used in cardiac arrest, severe allergic reactions, and sudden asthma attacks. In cardiac arrest, the dose is 1 mg with a dilution factor of 1:10,000, and it is administered every 3 to 5 minutes. For severe allergic reactions, the dose is 0.3 to 0.5 mg. Adrenaline is typically administered intravenously, but if a vein is not available or if needed, it can also be given intramuscularly into the muscle. The next drug is calcium gluconate, which is the calcium salt of gluconic acid. Calcium gluconate is used in hypocalcemia, low calcium levels in blood, cardiac arrest, hyperkalemia, high potassium levels in the blood, and magnesium toxicity. The dose of calcium gluconate is 0.5 mg per kg of body weight, administered through a 10% calcium gluconate infusion, typically over a 2 to 5 minute time frame. The route of administration is intravenous, meaning it is injected into the vein. The next drug is dopamine, which is actually a catecholamine neurotransmitter and a peripheral vasostimulant, meaning it acts on the blood vessels. Dopamine is used in cases of severe hypotension, very low blood pressure, such as 90 over 60 mm of mercury or lower than that, as well as in heart failure and shock. The dose of dopamine for severe hypotension is 10 to 20 microgram per kg per minute, while for heart failure, the dose is 5 to 10 microgram per kg per minute. The route of administration is intravenous, meaning it is injected into the vein. The next drug is Amiodarone. It is actually a class 3 antiarrhythmic drug. It is used in conditions such as atrial fibrillation, ventricular fibrillation, ventricular tachycardia, and wide complex tachycardia to normalize the heart rate. The dose of Amiodarone is 5 mg per kg and it is administered through an intravenous infusion over a time frame of 20 minutes to 2 hours. The route of administration is intravenous, meaning it is injected into the vein. The next drug is adenosine. Like Amiodarone, adenosine is an antiarrhythmic drug, but it specifically blocks the atrioventricular AV node, which slows the heart rate. Adenosine is used in conditions such as supraventricular tachycardia, paroxysmal supraventricular tachycardia, and Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. The dose of adenosine typically starts at 6 mg and it is administered intravenously via rapid IV push, as its half-life is very short, 0.6 to 10 seconds. This means it needs to be used quickly within that short time frame. The next drug is magnesium sulfate, which is the magnesium salt of sulfuric acid. Magnesium sulfate is used in conditions such as hypomagnesemia, very low magnesium levels in the body, torsades de pointis, this is basically a type of arrhythmia with a very fast heart rate, eclampsia, that is high blood pressure during pregnancy with fits and seizures, and severe acute asthma. The dose of magnesium sulfate for torsades de pointis is 2 gram administered slowly. For eclampsia, the dose is 2 to 4 gram and it is given over 5 minutes. For asthma, the dose is 2 gram administered over 15 minutes. The route of administration is intravenous, meaning it is injected into the vein. The next drug is hydrocortisone, which is a steroid drug. It is used in conditions such as shortness of breath, that is difficulty in breathing, severe allergic reactions, inflammation, and swelling. The dose of hydrocortisone is 5 mg per kg body weight for children, and for adults, the dose ranges from 100 to 300 mg. The route of administration can be either intravenous or intramuscular depending on the situation. Thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please like, comment, subscribe, and share with your friends. See you in the next video.